We need to find a better way, guys. We need to find a better way.
Fly the Mega Aerodactyl.
Holy shit! For fuck's sake, just get the shit out of me. I have no idea what this thing over here is, but I want to find out. It appears that we have hackers on the server? Sandman, you are literally flying right now. I don't know how you're doing it, but you're flying. Please stop hacking. All right, guys, I want everyone to go ahead and report Sandman for hacking in Ark. Look at that. Clear fly hacks right now. Clear fly hacks. Now, it seems that he somehow, like, logged out while he was on his pterodactyl or pterodon or Mr. Jefferson, as I should be saying it, and has just fallen completely off. So, Sandman might want to check next time you log out because you are pretty vulnerable right now. But anyways, guys, welcome back to a brand new episode of the Ark Survival Series here on the Ark server with all the YouTubers. Now, guys, we are walking among an intruder. So apparently, in the last episode with Vic and Sandman, they discovered that someone had actually gotten on the server, that guessed the password, and is on the server just running amok. Now, I don't know if she is on right now, and she goes by the name Lil Girl 20. All right, Lil Girl 20. And she said she guessed the password, came on, and just started playing. It was actually really bad. I just got back from watching the video that Vic made, and she was just like, all right, guys, if you know why I'm here, it's because I guessed your password. But she was like really mad cool, and she seemed pretty bent. So we're actually letting her stay on the server. We gave her the password, apparently Vic did or whatnot, the new password. And guess what the old password was, and guess who set the old password? So I'm in charge of the whole server, and I set the old password. The old password, like, okay, so if you check right here on the tab, this server is called the Pack Ark server. Yeah, probably not the best start. Anyway, password was actually just the pack, no space, with capital T and capital P. That was the password. But it has definitely been changed, so don't even bother joining right now. It has been changed, and I'm really just hoping that Lil Girl 20 doesn't go on a rampage and destroy everything, because we would be very screwed and probably lose the whole series. But yeah, shout out to Lil Girl 20. Hopefully see you around the server. You're not on right now. She's got some tames. She's like level 20, and we felt bad to ban her and just kick her out of the server. So she's gonna be playing. She's just gonna be banned. But I might have a bone to pick with Lil Girl 20. I logged in and I was missing my pike, my sickle, and my pick. Miola didn't take it, Vic didn't take it, Rob said he didn't take it. He probably did. But yeah, we're missing that. I wanna find out and get to the bottom of who took it, all right? I wanna find out and I'm gonna find out. Now, if that was Lil Girl 20, you better watch out. No one goes ahead and take that. If you do that, I will kill your Trikeosaurus. And I will kill your hummingbird. Oh, let's not forget the green giant. I don't know how she started out with just like a Bronto. I don't know how she did that. And she's also got this like cute little name, like storage and crafting unit. Like, this is her place. And I can't go in because it's locked. But I kind of want to like destroy it and see what's inside in case she's got like some mad like just crack house or something in there. I have no idea. But yeah, very interesting and something we will have to keep our eyes on. But very banterous at the same time. We just got to watch out. So yeah, guys, a lot of things have happened since the last episode of Ark. Miola has been on a next level grind. Now, I'm going to show you, you've probably already seen it in the intro, but, or maybe you haven't, actually. I don't think I looked at it, but he's been setting up a little camp over here on his raft. I want to get a raft set up with the same kind of stuff as my nice little, like, I guess, work raft. He's got one right here. I want to have one the same kind of deal. Has he got a water skin on that one? I don't even know if that is a water skin. But he's got this all set up. He's got some new aerodactyls. He's got a new panda. This is actually really sick. He's got an Argy that's, like, completely albino and looks just like the Al Hedwig. I actually really rate that. That's such a sick name. And then he's got, of course, the Rock Scorpion, which I tried to work with last episode. I think he changed the name. We're getting a new one. But yeah, he actually used that bad boy, guys. Are you ready to see this? You're not ready. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. He went ahead and found himself a Quetzal. Now, not even just this. I think it's pronounced Quetzal, Quasal, whatever you want to say. He found one in the sky, and I didn't realize they were this big when I was actually trying to hunt one down. I think this was the same one that I actually found, because he said it was level 2. In his words, he said it wasn't worth it, but I got it anyway because they're so rare. But level 2 apparently isn't really good for these things. I don't know. But the higher the level, the way harder they are to knock out. But yeah, he couldn't resist it, and he went ahead and tamed one of these bad boys. And I didn't even know he had enough levels, but he had enough levels and made a Quetzal. And he's got a lot of spoiled meat, which I'm actually going to take off him right now. Because off-screen before I started this episode, I actually farmed up a lot of Narco Berries. Because I wanted to go ahead... Where the... Trikey, did you eat all the friggin' berries? Oh, that's not the one. It's Trikey McTrikeface. All right, sorry, damn. I was like, where'd that go? Right, so I'll take all these narco berries because I need some narcotics and whatnot. But I'm going to really take that guy for a flight or something, test flight. I don't know. See how he goes. So spoiled meats in there and narco berries. And let's make a whole lot of drugs. Make 15 of them total. And then we can use those for some tranquilizer arrows, which we're going to use later today. But another thing I want to check up on is hopefully getting some ammo for the shotgun. I really want to try the shotgun out and see if I can get it to work for something. But I do need to buy some or build some ammo for this thing, which I have no idea how to make. So I'm going to quickly type in here, shotgun. I don't even know if I've unlocked it yet with my level. I actually have. So I need simple shotgun ammo. And to get this, I need to have, wow, I can get a pump action shotgun. Powerful up close, but less reliable with range. Can fire multiple times before reloading. Very powerful up close, but less reliable with range. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and ask if this is reliable for trying to take down like primals and whatnot. I don't know if it is. I've never used any guns in Ark, so we'll find out, I guess. I could try to go for a fabricated pistol or something. I don't know. I just don't have any pistols. I want to try them out. But yeah, essentially today, we're just going to get started on some pistols and some guns. But, and a little bit of grinding. A little bit of grinding. I want to set things up and all that jazz. Actually, no, we're not going to do guns this episode. I might build some shotgun ammo, but that's about it. And the main thing I want to do is try and get a little boat like Miola so I can go ahead and try to do this little grind tactic that I think he's already doing, but I want to try as well. Blue Banter Boys. What do you call that? The Smithy. The Smithy. Who's Blue Banter Boys? I think we changed our name to Blue Banter Boys. Sick. Okay, so for me to be able to learn the shotgun ammo, I need to learn pistol ammo, and learn that, I need gunpowder. So let's learn gunpowder, and then let's learn the simple bullet, okie dokie, and then let's learn the simple shotgun ammo. Didn't even take that many Ingram points, and we have so many, considering the last episode we took down that Primal Carno, and we nearly took down that Primal Raptor. We didn't actually in the end, but just a ton of XP drops in the end of it, so, you know, easy bangers, really. Alright, and then to go ahead and craft those simple things, it looks like we have to go to the smithy, it seems, and weapons, ammo, and let's see here. To make this, we're going to need 3 simple bullets, so we have to make these anyway, and that is 1 metal ingot. I think we're going to have to go for a metal ingot run, and this was going to have to happen sooner or later, and I know the best way to make it happen, so let's go make it happen. So I'm going to be taking everybody with me right now. I'm going to go on the serious metal run of a lifetime. How much weight can a Quetzal hold? I imagine it'd be crazy. 820? Holy crap. Okay, I'm going to up his movement speed a little bit. I don't really want to change his stats too much because it is Miola's. I don't know how he wants to work it, but there's no point in wasting, like, its stamina and whatnot. So I'm going to just, you know, just chuck on movement speed for now. Hopefully he won't get really mad at me for doing the move speeds. I'll do a melee damage just to make sure I get it all. This guy's like a T-Rex in the sky, is what I've heard. And I can't wait to get my own. But this is for me and Miola. I'm going to go ahead and get a crap ton of metal. And I'm going to use a lot of these mounts to get that. So I don't know what your move speed is in comparison to a bird. Let's fly him for the first time here. He seems pretty fast. Yeah, I'd say he's comparable to the pterodons. I'll ride with you. I'll ride with you, buddy. I'll ride with you for sure, mate. For sure, mate. All right, but the birds are where the problem lies. See, these things are slow as shit. So we're gonna go ahead and just chuck some stamina, make sure they're nice birds that can actually follow us and whatnot. Pidgeot, you're coming with me. I'm taking all the birds, guys. I'm taking them all, and they're all coming with me. I'm just maxing movement speed for now. I guess I don't really need stamina because they don't have anything on top of them that will reduce that. I don't know if I even want to take the pterodons unless they're really high level. Please work, which is that one I got last episode. He can carry a little bit, I suppose, up the movement speed, up the weight a little bit. I suppose he could actually take some stuff. Tame, I don't sure this is. Tame 43, what does that even mean? Anyway, movement speed, melee damage, and a little bit of weight. He's level 40, I don't know what level, it must be level 29. Level comes first, right? No, level 29, and now he's 43. No, he's level 50. I'm so confused. Where'd the Quetzal go? Did anybody see the Quetzal go anywhere? He just flat out disappeared. Why are you over there? Scared the shit out of me, dude. What the fuck? All right. What the actual fuck was that? It just disappeared, went to the other island, was like, screw you guys, I'm out of here. I just want to make sure I'm amassing everybody here. That guy, and that guy. I just want to make sure all the levels up on these guys. Sure, okay, this is going to be an army, guys. We are getting every single piece of metal where we're going, and I'll tell you that much for now, for sure. All right, so let's take that guy. Let's take that guy. Let's take that guy. And any more other birds to take with us? Oh, I could pick one up on the Argy as well if I wanted to take like a... Wait a second. Idea. Okay. All right. Just you. Stop, everybody. I don't know if the Quetzals can pick things up. I would assume that they cannot. So I'm going to go ahead and... Nope. Which one's got the saddle? Oh, he took the saddle back off one of these guys. He probably put it on his. All right. I guess I'll ride his then, which is the, this guy over here, Captain Falcon. All right. I've got all the flying mounts. Come with me. In total, we're going to have so many flying mounts. It's actually going to be dumb. All right. So what I wanted to test here, stop. I wanted to test to see if I could pick up the Ankylosaur, bring it with me to try and get more. He does seem kind of heavy and would wreck his claws, but I don't care. Try anyway, buddy. It's probably just so heavy, like... Because this guy can mine metal really good, but he's so heavy. I think it can actually take things. I wonder if I can take Slowpoke here. Oh my god. We have a Slowpoke! Alright, so this is gonna be such a meta idea. I'm gonna bring Slowpoke to try and shot down. Wait, we're gonna need a saddle for this guy. But yeah, I'm gonna use him to try and take all of the metal down, and then I'm gonna put him all in the birds, bring back around 600 pieces of metal, and just have just a bunch of metal, really. And hopefully it should be really good for all of us involved to just have a bunch of resources. Because with metal becoming the resource to be used for a lot of things, including guns, bullets, metal, picks, all that jazz, I mean, it's just good to have. All right, so the first thing I gotta do ahead and learn here is the Ankylosaur saddle. Can be crafted at the smithy. So let's go ahead and look at this bad boy. So saddles, the Ankylosaur saddle is going to require a lot more hide. There's a little deposit, and it's going to require two more metal ingots. So let's try and see if these rocks over here have come back alive and want to go ahead and give me some more metal. Are you a metal rock? No, none of you are rocks, guys. Need metal, and that's three pieces of metal. All right. Do you guys even drop hides? Are you a dead fish? You're going to be dead now. All right, so hide, I believe, is the axe. Getting a decent amount. Nothing crazy. Does this thing even drop hide? No, it doesn't. Sick. All right, let's work on getting some hide while this thing lights up. Of course, I am going to need some more wood out of that one as well. Oh, and I have none left. Sick banter, boys. Literally just going to go ahead and just start attacking everything for their hides. Like, I'm sorry, Mr. Trike, I didn't mean for this to happen, but you just have the resources that I need. All right, so we've got enough hide. We just need two pieces of metal ingots. I think this last one's about to go in. I really hope that actually works because, of course, it's RNG. Whether or not the thing gets defined, I guess is the correct word use, into the, fine forge, whatever, into the next metal, I think it's probably going to fail too. There's our cementing paste, which is from yours truly, the Beavers. Please be working here. We still got to get all the metal yet. Come on. This is going to be a lot more metal. I'm going to need so many things, like smelting these things. It's going to be madness. All right, we're going for emergency metal here. Just got some backups. Whoa, when did it get so crowded at the front door? I know everyone's keen to just get some metal. I know they're keen. See, look, I don't know why, but when it gets down to one metal, the thing never smelts. Nor do I. All right, there we go. The last piece of the puzzle. Let's go ahead, chuck these all in and craft ourselves up the Ankylosaur saddle. Chuck that on Slowpoke, and then it is off to get copious amounts of the metals. Alright, and we've got a cheeky level up on the way as well. Level 55, might get some new crafting things as well. I'm going to go ahead and just pop one on movement speed. And what do we unlock with that latest level? Let's have a look. Bunch of gates, air conditioner, refrigerator, Bronto saddle. Ooh. We can ride the Bronto. Might have to get that. We've also unlocked the Argentavis saddle, so we now can ride, or we can make one for our own bird. Castoroid saddle. Oh, sick. We can ride the Beavers finally, and which we don't have. Advanced bullet consumes. Is there anything on here that you think I definitely need to make? Because we're going to make the new house hopefully soon. We're going to go up north with a bunch of people and just transfer over. I don't know about the T-Rexes though. They might get really annoying to take over. So boats, I think we can still take them over on. It'll be a travel. It'll be an episode. Hopefully it won't be too annoying. All right, the moment you've all been waiting for. I would love to make a spare pickaxe. Actually, no, I don't need to. Slowpoke's got everything candled. All right, here we go. The moment we've all been waiting for. Let's go ahead and grab everything. I was about to make a spare pickaxe, but then I realized that I won't need to do so. So let's make sure we get everything right here. Mega Aerodactyl, Argentavis over here as well. Let's see here. It's going to be hard picking these guys apart. All right, there we go. All the birds are now following me. And the Quetzal's much faster than, so I just gotta try and bait them around over here and then pick up the Slowpoke. And I think we've got him. Perfect. And now we are on our way to go mine. This is the miner squad. Me and four other birds plus Slowpoke. This is literally the boys, the miner squad right now. Good thing is the Quetzal isn't too much faster than the Argy, so it's actually kind of better. I guess the Aerodactyls just get my face the whole time. All right, so the closer the better, I'm just gonna try and find the closest metal reserve and just go ham. And as you can see now, the difference in levels of speed, the white bird is he's trying his best, but Hedwig, I think it's Hedwig. Yeah, Hedwig is just getting left behind in the dust. He must be his attacking bird or something. All right, I'm hoping this will be enough. I'm gonna change everybody to follow the Quetzal now so I can put the Quetzal down and they'll all stay around that instead of following me around. And let's get him to drop that Slowpoke. It looks like he did. Perfect. Okay, you follow me over here. Oh, I'm going to give you your saddle, by the way. So let's go ahead and... oh, I didn't take it out of the thing. Idiot. Back we go. Alrighty, we are back. And everybody is hopefully in one piece. Seems that we're all enjoying ourselves here. Okie dokie. So let's just sit right down here and put this little saddle on our boy Slowpoke. Oh, he's still following me. No. All right, you, go away. All right, so this is going to be interesting. This is the first time I've ever used this bad boy. I'm going to go ahead and up his melee damage because I know that that actually increases the amount that he'll farm, I hope. So here we go. How much does this guy get per hit? Let's go. Oh, we accidentally hit a berry bush there, but we got 58 pieces of metal? What? This guy can hold a weight of 265, so he nearly almost caps himself out after every hit. Sick. All right, so I'm going to be resourceful here and drop it every time that we farm one. I'm not sure how long it lasts on the floor. Let's just check here for every 2 minutes. So I have to, like, chuck it on this bad boy. I am a little worried that he is a little low on the weight kind of things, and the metal does actually become a little... Oh, sorry, the stone does become a bit of a problem here. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that block. No! Why is it doing that with his tail? It seems to do everything behind him. Why are you doing this? He's farming too many berries. You're not doing what you're meant to be doing, dude. He is technically a herbivore, though, so that's probably why he's doing that. I think it's the direction I face is what he breaks. There we go. No one ever said farming metal would be easy, and it is certainly not that. I'll tell you that much. It is actually very hard to do this little resource here. And it looks like I only need to take this guy, because his weight, I don't even know if I'm going to use the other birds, just because it's so annoying, because I wish Slowpoke could hold more weight than he actually can, because he seems to just be really annoying and doesn't be able to hold that much. Could you just stop breaking the ones behind us? There we go. That's the one. That's the money. You know, I'm going to have the Quetzal follow us now while we do this little process here. Just because it'll make everything easier. He can come follow me around while I farm and get me stuck when I need to as well. All right, here we go. Let's get that one. Let's not do that. There we go. Side shots. And again. Oh, what the hell was that? Bangers. I gotta, like, turn around with him. It's crazy. It's very troublesome to get the metal on him. I will not lie, and we'll take tips from people who can improve my my methods. Wow, we're actually getting cold up on the mountain? What the hell? Okay. All right, let's just get these last few metal. I'm going to stop at every 60 or so, and then get off, and then that should be my method there, I hope. All right, this is a much better process I've got going now. If I just, like, lock... Oh, those weren't actual pieces of stone. Or metal. Exhilarating content, by the way, I know. Alright, this guy's weight is way over the limit right now, so we are going to disperse this into some birds, and I think at that point I'm going to go ahead and probably stop all of this, I guess you could say, at that stage. So 80, is that enough to encumber myself? No, it is not. I'm going to go ahead, chuck some on Hedwig. These guys can carry a lot, and I know they can. Let's go ahead, and that should be, yeah, easy bangers. And then I'll grab another one off of you, Quetzal. Yeah, look at you. You're trying to move around, and you're having such a hard time doing it. Now you're at, oh my god, this guy's having such a hard time. I'm just going to chuck it all in one bird, just to make it easy. The sun's going down. We're actually getting cold out here, so we got to bounce. Let's go ahead, chuck it on him. He's still getting levels and whatnot. Quetzal's now finally moving, but we got to pick up the Slowpoke and ride him home. So this is going to be, you know, an interesting way to go about it. I'll probably grab this whole stack, and now he's at a weight of 572. Should be perfectly fine. I'm going to chuck it on this guy just to even things out. And let's see what my weight is on this guy. When I'm riding, it is 643, but what if we pick up Slowpoke? All right, off we go home, bringing back about 600 pieces of metal. Can't argue with that. Don't know if I would take Slowpoke next time. I feel like I would get just about the same amount of metal, maybe even quicker without him. But it's nice to bring him along, give him some experience on the job. We're actually going so much slower than the rest of the birds because we weigh an absolute crap ton. Well, screw it. I'll go with it. All right, let me just check something here. If I press E, I got a parachute. I got a parachute. It's fine. And then I want to go ahead and go one of these birds over here and give you some metal. Had it like dem apples. All right, and then I go back onto my boy. Now we're good. Thank you to all the four birds who did pretty much nothing the whole trip. Oh, do we still have slope? Oh, shit. We dropped him. Fuck. All right, this is a rescue mission. I repeat. This is a rescue mission. All right, guys. I don't know how I feel about this. We dropped him off around here. Oh, there he is. He's still following us. Oh, no. This is not a good place to be. All right. Although I'm still slower than these birds, and they're still giving me a hard time because I just picked up Slowpoke, we're now officially going home, I hope. All righty. And we are about to land. Let's all land right here in the airfield. Oh, I can't wait for the new house. We should make an airfield or something. All right, and just like that, I want everybody to follow me, all eyes on me, and then at sudden, I want them to stop. Okay, now how do I get the metal off of you into here? All right, so Quetzal, follow me. Follow me for a hot second, eh? A hot second. All right, and chill. All right, I got a two-way system here. I'm trying to see if I can pick it up and access the... Yes, I can. All right, ready? Pick up, access... Put it all in. All right, that's the method right now. I really should have kept these all on one, but because I am very bad, I did not do that. Here, you follow me. And who was the other guy that took it? I think it was Pidgeot. Alrighty, well, that is probably most of the metal that I've ever gotten in Ark. No, definitely the most metal ever. So I don't know how many pieces total. I'm going to chuck all these in and then tally it up. But I think it's around 600 pieces. So that is actually crazy. Hopefully that'll refine down to about 400 ingots. I'm really hoping. So let's see here. I'm going to do the quick math. Wow, that is 818 pieces. We nearly got, I'm just double checking here. Yeah, we nearly got 1,000 pieces of metal. So hopefully that'll refine down. I don't know what the rate is. I may actually check the wiki. I didn't check it in any of these guys on the rush, did I, at any chance? It's four birds. I only see, yeah, Captain Falcon. I didn't chuck any on you, did I? No, I did not. Oh, he's got some things in here. Let's chuck all these bad boys in, and let's get it smelted down. And while it's smelting, I'll check for the rate. But we're going to need a lot of wood to actually get this going. So I'm going to visit our beavers for some wood. All right. Wow, that is a lot of stuff there. Where'd my weight go up to? Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Okay, they're coming now. They're coming. Yeah. Oh, wow. Did I just kill a... Okay, no. This is a bad place to be. Castoroid, I will roll. That is one big fish. Okay, come on. Let's go, beaver. Let's go. And now you are dead. I hope you enjoyed your time here. Ah, damn it. You made me all heavy. My chitin boots broke. Ah, why you do this? But hopefully that should be enough. Wait, that was actually enough to start sprinting. Hell yeah. Yeah, I'm going to check the stuff on and check the rates for the metal ingots. But yeah, if we get around 600-700 pieces of metal, that's a lot of stuff we can do. We can make a full set of flak, whatever. It's just going to be good amount of resources to have on us. So I'm really happy with today's performance. Filled up to the brim. Light that thing up, get some charcoal out of there, and let's see how we can do that and see how much we can get. Suppose in the meantime, we might as well repair our Chintin boots as well. I want to dye these things, so hopefully I will dye them very soon. saw Miola and Vic do it in the last episode. Vic looks like the Master Chief. He's like wearing Halo gear. All right, so I've been completely mistaken. It's not a percentage chance of it turning into a metal ingot. It's actually that two metal, just metal turn into two metal. Yeah. Two pieces of metal will turn into one metal ingot. Just found that out. And the Industrial Forge can produce up to 40 metal ingots at once. And it looks like it gets quicker and quicker, but the refining forge actually takes a while. 100 metal ingots will take around half an hour to cook up. So that's going to be gone for a while. I just want to make sure I have enough, stuff to work with in terms of wood. Hopefully that's enough. Hopefully it'll craft it up. And if not, I'll just keep filling it up with wood in the spare time. I'm probably going to go grab one more stack of wood, actually, to go chuck that in and then grab the metal out and then I'll make another one. So, yeah, let's get one more stack of wood in here and then that should hopefully be good to go. Alrighty, so we're going to go ahead and chuck in our last piece of, wood for the product. I keep doing that every time. I'm just thinking that E will get me straight in. And it is nice and stocked up. There we go. We'll chuck the rest of the metal ingots in here. I'll send me all a Skype message. Let him know that there is a lot of metal coming on the way. And I guess that'll be good for future episodes and whatnot. I guess I can make some shotgun bullets. Actually, let's make some of the shotgun bullets now. Let's actually do that. I know I can't make many. I want to test out the shotgun. Fire this shotgun. So a lot of you guys at home ask for, on the comment section, hour-long episodes of Ark. Funny thing is, I record these episodes an hour to an hour and a half, but I cut them down to around half hour, sometimes shorter if there's a lot of flying in between. Obviously, I like to cut out all the boring parts if there are any. I mean, sometimes, like I said, with travel, it gets a little annoying, so I cut those out. But just remember, guys, I am playing for a long time. It's just that a lot of it doesn't make it to YouTube. But I will try and consider longer episodes of Ark because you guys just bloody love the series. So I'll try and see what I can do. But sometimes transit, like flying around that pterodactyl's like, I think I played for an hour and a half and I cut it down to 20 minutes because just flying on the birds was just so annoying. We need to find a better way, guys. We need to find a better way.
Fly the mega pterodactyl.
Holy shit! For fuck's sake, just get the shit out of me. Alrighty, it was a lengthy process, but I'm going to be going ahead and crafting one shot. That's all I get is one shot from all that crafting. I'm gonna need to do some grinding, that is for sure. But let's get it out here, load up the shotgun. Oh, I actually don't want to waste it. I actually don't want to waste it here. Let's have a look. Wait.
You sent one of Little Girl's dinos.
Nah. Should I?
I joke, I joke. No, no, don't.
No, should I? For like, cause no, I was saying, like, no, she might have taken some of my stuff here.
I could shoot
John right in the face. He's right next to me. He's actually hacking right now. Should I shoot him for hacking? Like, what's he doing? He's flying in the air right now. He's actually flying. I think I might just punish him a little bit. Much punish him. I actually am, like, interested to see how much damage the shotgun does. Is there, like, a dodo that I can find here? I thought there was a dodo over here. Oh, there's a dodo.
Surely a one-shot dodo.
Oh, should I shoot her dingo? It's her dodo.
No, we don't need to start this war.
Yeah, no, all right, little girl, I will not shoot your dodos. But I need to find a dodo to shoot. Where are the dodos? I'll go to Josh's dodos and shoot one. I need to test it. I need to test the dodos. All right, here we go. I found two dodos. I'm going to try and line them up for a collateral headshot here. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, bang. Yeah, it did nothing. Yeah, shotguns didn't even kill a dodo. Shotguns are shit. Confirmed.